1941, of course, the war broke out, and all schools were all suspended. And we had Japanese school. We had to go to the Japanese school. It was compulsory. So we went and studied. Everybody had to study Japanese. We used to get, for recess, we get a small bun. No, I wouldn't say a bun, a little loaf, which is as hard as brick. I don't know what they use. Anyway, we had to eat that. There was no other food. Food was very, very scarce. Everything. In the night, my father had to go and queue up for bread and a little bit of rice and some vegetables. In the night, they had to go and queue up. My father also was getting old and all that. So we went through hardship during the Japanese time. We were so cooperative. There were 8 houses. And all of us were young children, not even teenagers, 13, 14, most of them. And so we used to group together. Those days already, this community came in during the Japanese time because there was nothing else, you see, we have to communicate. So there were Eurasians, there were Tamils, there were Chinese. So all of us children, we get together, parents get together. When it came to 45, when the British came back. So we had to go back to our Raffles Girls' school. So our school was used, the Raffles Girls' building was used as the Kempeitai Japanese prison. So we had to function in the St. Anthony's Convent, which is now Nanyang something in Middle Road. So we went to that school, and one of the Raffles teachers came. And I being close, and my father insists that I go there and help out, I went there as one of the first students. I only finished my standard 5 in 1941. But then I was very mature, being the eldest in the family. I did so much things during Japanese time. And mother would always make me do all the pounding and cutting firewood and all that I did. That's how I am so strong now still. Whereas my 2 younger sisters, they are very softies. My mother doesn't ask them to do anything much because I was the strongest in the family. I did all that. So therefore, I went to that school, St. Anthony's Convent. The Raffles functioned there. And this teacher said, "You're good, you have come, you finished your standard 5 already. You need to help me." So as the children come, I have to register them. That's already my groundwork for community service. I was about 14 plus, and I was able to do all that. And then as the children come, she will say, "Okay, I think this one can go to this class, this one can go." And then some of my relatives or friends come, I will just, you know, we skip classes. We missed a few years already, so we skip classes. So I'll take them and go and put them in a higher class, you know. But somehow or other they coped, and so did I. I jumped from standard 5, I missed my 6 and 7. I went to the 8th standard. But in the meantime, I'm helping out, taking these children to the different classrooms and all that. And we are so short of teachers. So that lady teacher will tell me, "Okay, you give them some spelling to do. Or you make them read something." Those days we had the book called Fundamental English, so we used to use that. So I will teach, as young as I was, spelling, maths, some English, just to keep the children busy. So that way I started life like that.